In the last video, we looked at how scaling out operates in the Kairos platform. We saw how a position with two contracts can be scaled with an initial eight tick sliding stop. Then when the position reached four ticks of profit, one contract was exited and the stop was tightened to four tick sliding stop. From that point, the remaining one contract either stopped out after a four tick pullback or when it hit the profit target at 20 ticks. In this video, I'll show how to configure the stops, targets, and scaling out targets in the Kairos platform.
This material is for educational purposes only, and the content should not be construed as being a recommendation of any kind. No representation is being made that any trading system or method is likely to achieve profits or losses similar to the ones discussed here. Now let's get started. The links to the documentation are listed in the comments section below. Let's go to the Configure Modules window. These two tabs, the stop exit and the target exit, configure the executions for the hands-free system. Once the position is entered, after an instrument meets conditions on the conditions tab, then the position will be exited when it's either stopped out or when it hits a target that's configured in these two tabs. There is a third way that a position can be exited. If the condition in the exit box of the conditions tab is met, then it will also exit the position. Let's go through the parameters for the stop tab. First, you select the stop type. There are 21 types of stop types in total, but they are extensions of two main types, fixed and sliding. There are three different modes that can be used, percentage, tick, and dollar. These five terms are combined in various ways to determine how the stop behaves. In addition, there is the adjust term, which is used when scaleouts are used for targets, which tightens the stops as scaleout leg targets are reached. In all, there are 21 different types of stops. The links in the comments section have documentation on all 21 types of stops. Stop value is the amount of the stop. The stop type determines how the stop value is used. For example, if you're using a tick stop, stop value will be the number of ticks for the instrument. If you're using a dollar stop, then stop value will be the stop in dollars. And if you're using a percentage, then stop value is used as a percentage, and so on. The next three parameters, closing strategy, tolerance, and stop price strategy, determine what kind of order is sent when the stop is triggered. The options for closing strategy are market, limit, and limit persist. If you select market, then it sends a market order, and the tolerance and stop price strategy are not used. If limit or limit persist are selected, then tolerance and stop price strategy are enabled. Tolerance and stop price strategy parameters determine the price that is sent for the limit order based on the current bid ask when triggered and the tolerance.
We're not going to go over how the limit price is calculated by the wholesale, retail, and tolerance settings in this video. You can see that how that works in a video titled Configuring Market Limit and Limit Persist Orders in stop and target tabs. But for now, let's set it to split bid ask, which ignores the tolerance setting and uses limit price of the midpoint of the bid ask.
Next, we have the block after close selection. This is either a yes or no. This determines whether you want to re-enter the position after it stopped out and the entry conditions are met again. If yes, then it will re-enter the position after a stop out. If you select no, then it will block the position from entering again, even if the entry conditions are met. If set to yes, the position will be put in the blocked symbols window, where you can unblock it manually if you want. Finally, you select the stop route. If you are configuring a trading system for futures, then you can ignore the route selection because it will automatically send it through the correct route. If you're developing a trading system for equities, then you can use Smart or one of the other routes for equities like Arca, Island, NYSE, which Interactive Brokers uses. For Forex, select Ideal Pro. Now let's look at the Target Exit tab, which is very similar to the Stop Exit tab. There are five types of targets: fixed, fixed tick, percentage, fixed dollar, and scale out. The first four target types, the parameters are the same as for stops. But if you select scaleout, then it shows you this table. Each row of the table is a leg of the scaleout, and each row has a setting corresponding to the settings of the target exit tab, with some differences. The position index numbers each leg of the scaleout, so one will be for the first target or leg, two will be for the second larger target or leg, and so on. You're not limited to two legs or targets, you can have as many as you want. In the type column, you select fixed, fixed tick, percentage, or fixed dollar. All legs need to be of the same type. The quantity works a little differently. It is the percentage of the current position that you want to exit for that leg. For example, if you initially take a two contract position and you want to scale out 50% or one contract, then you'll set the quantity at 50%. For the second leg, you exit 100% of the remainder of the position or one contract, so you set the second quantity value to 100%. The scale value determines how far into profit the position gets before the scale out order is sent. The first leg has to reach four ticks for the first two contracts, after which it will exit one contract. The second contract has to reach 20 ticks of profit without being stopped out first. The rest of the parameters are the same. You have strategy, tolerance, and price strategy, which determines the type of order sent when the target is hit. Strategy will be market, limit, or limit persist, and when price strategy is split bid ask, the tolerance value is ignored. The order route is set here. Again, if you're trading futures, the order route is selected automatically for interactive brokers. Then you have the cancel timeout and block reentry parameters. You can edit the values by selecting a row and pressing edit, modify the values in the controls at the top, which correspond to the values below, then press save. You can add or delete a leg by selecting add row or delete row, press save all, exit the order scaleout window, then the modified legs will appear in the table, after which you press save for the module to save all the changes. Now you're ready to scale out of your positions. This works for futures, Forex, or equity trades.
I'd like to share with you a free special report called Easy Profit Optimization. In this report, you will learn how to increase profitability by 40% without changing your trade entry conditions, reduce risks by 60% without making emotion-based decisions that will reduce profits, and increase your chances to make a break-even trade rather than a loss. You don't have to invest in a system to start taking advantage of this strategy right away. Once you've read my special report, you can immediately apply this method for more profitable trading. Thank you for your time and attention. Please comment below. Let me know what topics you'd like to see covered in the future videos. See you in the next video. Happy Algo Trading.